Welcome to online class. In today's class, we'll discuss regarding the five-step problem solving approach. So the five-step problem solving approach assists in the identification and elimination of root causes to problems. But what is a problem? A problem is a deviation from the standard. It is something that wasn't expected and could be something like poor on time delivery, poor quality, taking too long in the process, poor information flow, re-entering data in a spreadsheet, then correcting a mistake, high internal scrap, okay, and so on. So it can be absolutely anything that creates an output that is not to plan. Okay, that is known as what? Problem. Again, the art of being competitive in business is how quickly you can use problem solving strategies as an culture to find problems at source and eliminate them. An alternative technique is the five-step approach, which is a simpler alternative which may help a team quickly understand and try new ideas to resolve the problem at hand. Okay, so one way of solving problem is the five-step method. Then what this five-step method include is the five questions. Okay, what are those questions and what it means, we'll understand one by one. What is the problem? The first question is what? What is the problem? The first stage of the five-step problem solving model is to define exactly what the problem is. Be clear and specific as to what exactly the problem is when it happens. How often? What effect is it? What is the deviation from standard? See problem statement for more information. Next comes is what is my plan? Next question is what is my plan? Think of at least two or three possible methods that you might use to identify what went wrong. In other words, where and what do you need to investigate to help determine the cause? A strategy is a way or method or process for understanding the root causes. Okay. The next question is what might happen if? See, examine your list of possible strategies from section 2, that is the question 2, and choose the one that seems to fit best for the problem at hand. Okay, next question is try it out, that is, work the strategy which you choose in step 3 and determine whether your team found the cause. If you did, then move on to the next step. The next step is major, that is, major is the process outputs, and if the problem has gone, you are done. If your best strategy doesn't work, go back to your list of possible strategies in step 2 and choose another. Keep passing through the steps until your measurements tell you the problem has gone. Okay, so this is known as what? Five-step problem solving strategy. Okay, hope the concept is clear. We'll move to the next concept, that is the FEMA tool. The FEMA expansion is failure modes effects analysis. Okay, tool. It is a powerful method for understanding potential problems to processes before they happen. Think of it as being a forecasting tool to allow the team using it to design quality and safety into a product and process by eliminating the possible problems that could happen before they happen. So it has been used extensively in safety critical industries like aerospace business and has become popular in the automotive industry due to the same requirements. Now, what are the benefits of this FEMA tool? The benefits of an effective and systematic use of FEMA tool are vast. Okay, notwithstanding the obvious benefits above, FEMAs can create smooth production process first time, reduced development costs, increased profit margins in production, and the ability to successfully win more business supplying competitive and long-lasting product. Then what are the additional benefits? It minimizes product failures and it helps to identify the risk in an early stage, then track process improvements will take place, documented evaluation, then develop efficient test plans. Okay, the FEMA tool is a means of identifying failures before they happen by providing a checklist procedure that is built around three key questions. First question is, what is the likelihood that failure will occur? What would the consequences of that failure be? Then how likely is such a failure to be detected before it affects the customer? Now, how to create an FEMA? The first thing is, review the process. That is, map the process in question. Step by step, you frame the process, capturing every value added activity. Okay, the next step is identify failure modes. That is, for each process step, brainstorm all potential failure modes. Think regarding the all potential failure modes. Things that could go wrong with that particular activity. Okay, next step is list the effects and causes. For each failure mode, list its effect on the output of that process step and also the real root cause. Okay, then give each item a severity score. That is, you have to rank each failure mode as to how severe the failure mode could be. That is, scoring from 1 to 10 on the basis of its severe failure mode. Okay, next one is, give each item an occurrence score. That is, rank each failure mode as to how often it will or it does occur, scoring from 1 to 10. Okay, then give each item a detection score. That is, rank each failure mode as to how easy the failure mode can be detected by the next customer or next internal customer in the process. Okay, then calculate risk priority number. That is, for each failure mode, give it a risk priority number, which will be RPN. Okay, by multiplying the severity score into occurrence score into detection score. So this now allows you to focus on the highest scoring, higher risk problems first. Then develop an action plan. For each higher scoring RPN, that is risk priority number, note who is doing what by when to close, eliminate the failure modes. Okay, next step is take actions. That is, you have to take action, then recalculate new RPN, that is risk priority numbers. Once action has been taken, recalculate the new RPN numbers. Repeat the steps if further action is needed. That is, you have to repeat again the RPN number which is still too high. Okay, so this is regarding what FEMA tool. The next topic is exercises on problem solving. See, when something creates a problem, the performance or the status of the situation drops. Problem solving deals with finding out what causes the problem and then finding out the ways to solve the problem. Okay, the objective is what? To get the situation to where it should be. Okay, we'll understand this with the help of the example. A production line has an established run rate of 1000 items per hour. Okay, suddenly the run rate drops to 800 items per hour. Then ideas as to why this happened and solutions to repair the production line must be thought of, such as giving the worker a pay raise. Okay, so the creative problem solving is what? Using creativity, one must solve a problem in an indirect and unconventional manner. Again, we'll understand this creative problem solving with the help of this example. If a production line produced 1000 books per hour, creative problem solving could find ways to produce more books per hour. So, use the production line or reduce the cost to run the production line. So, what are the steps or what are the exercises to find the creative solutions for the problem? We'll understand one by one. First one is creative problem identification. Many of the greatest non-technological innovations are identified while realizing an improved process or design in everyday objects and tasks, either by accidental chance or by studying and documenting real-world experience. Next step is lateral problem solving. Lateral thinking will often produce solutions whereby the problem appears as obvious in hindsight. Okay, that lateral thinking will often lead to problems that you never knew you had, or it will solve simple problems that have a huge potential. Let us take an example. If a production line produced 1000 books per hour, lateral thinking may suggest that a drop in output to 800 would lead to higher quality, more motivated workers, and so on. Right, so this is what lateral problem solving. Next comes is lateral thinking puzzles. These are puzzles that are supposed to demonstrate what lateral thinking is about. However, any puzzle that has only one solution is not lateral. While lateral thinking may help you construct such puzzles. Okay, so the lateral thinking tools will seldom help you solve puzzles. Last one is group passing technique. Each person in a circular group writes down one idea and then passes the piece of paper to the next person, who adds the same thoughts. So this continues until everybody gets his or her original piece of paper back. So by this time, it is likely that the group will have intensively elaborated on each idea. The group may also create an idea book and post a distribution list or routing slip to the in front of the book. So on the first page is a description of the problem. The first person to receive the book lists his or her ideas and then routes the book to the next person on the distribution list. So the second person can log new ideas or add to the ideas of the previous person. So this continues until the distribution list is exhausted. A follow-up readout meeting is then held to discuss the ideas logged in the book. So this technique takes longer, but it allows individuals time to think deeply about the problem. So with this, we are done with the fifth unit. So what this unit tells in short, which will be the conclusion of the unit, is, see, it is common that every person is bound to face the problems in his life, in her or his life, right? So business is not an exception case. In every business, right from the formation stage till its closure, the problems keep on cropping up. So the success in business is decided on how quickly, effectively, and smoothly such problems are solved. The bundles of success is the way of gaining strength in business. So in order to survive and make one's mark in business circle, it is the successful facing of challenges in its way. So therefore, a successful entrepreneur's one more most and ever desired quality is to know the problems in advance and the techniques of solving them. So one is required to be proactive rather than reactive. Proactive method is to find the problem or the emergency problem one may adopt. Reactive method is, the proactive method is to find the problem positive solutions well before the problems arise, and only for emergency problems one may adopt what reactive method. So this unit has convinced about the important common techniques adopted to solve the problems of business. So with this, we are done with the fifth unit. Thank you.